Hello and welcome to another Nikomedia Quick Tip. So recently a lot of people have problems with these high poly objects and dynamics. And I think this because now with the in R20 with the volume measure we get things like this here. And no worries, we don't use the volume mesh in this, so we don't need R20 or something else. It's just made this to show you something like what you could get out of the volume measure. And you see this is a very high poly thing. And of course with this dynamics with this one is horrible. So this only a simple dynamic would work. So I think, so let's make a disk here. But this depends too on the machine you have. So this, I have a quite strong thing here. So this shouldn't have any problems here. So I make here the floor is a collider body and the volume mesh here, this is a rigid body. You find the text here in, on the simulation as well. So you have the collider body and the rigid body. And if you have some objects like this, be careful. Don't hit simply on play. Always go one frame forward to be careful, to be sure your cinema can handle it. So with G you go one frame forward. So with G, and if you see okay this works without problems, you can press play. Okay. Let's rotate this a little bit to get a little funnier thing here. Okay. But this is okay. But the problem is, let's say you want to make a soft body with this, or you have more things we could add now. I don't know, something with what you want, you can add it to here and put it in a connect object and make the connect object then. Dynamic and something else, and let's say we want to make here a soft body. I think now it will freeze, but I go to polygon and lines. So, and of course, be careful. Hit G for one frame forward, and when I hit G now, I see okay, it's gone one frame forward. I hit again G. It's still it's on frame 2, but it happened nothing here. So I know this won't work like this. So let's go back with Shift F or here on the thing. You see, it has a hard time to go back as well. So you see, it does not go back now. Let's hope that we didn't freeze now. It looks not good for us. No, nope. That's not really what I wanted. No, it looks like it's dead. Yes, but it's good that you see what I mean. Okay, so let's go to cinema. Inactive. So we make open it again. It's a little, and if I am lucky, I have it in my autosaves to this object. Let's see here on the side, my autosaves here. Oops, bring it in. Yep, okay, you see this is the volume measure. I make it current state to object and delete this. So. And then I make here low 720. Oh, I have my space, that's the only reason I do this. So, okay, now again I make a disk. It was good that it was like this, so you see exactly what I mean. Whoops. So, okay, and again the disk gets an collider body, measure gets in. No, the measure, not now. So I don't make it a high poly object dynamic now. I use a proxy object for this, a low poly proxy object. So what I mean with this is, let's make a cage around this object here. So I make a simple cylinder here. For this, the cage looks every time different, of course. So for every object, of course. Let's see. And the cage should cover the object. So something like this, okay. Well, make it even smaller, so like this, and bring it out. Let's start with this one here. Okay, make it editable. It wouldn't need so many subdivisions here, but it's okay. Good. Next step. It make it editable, the cylinder. So I have hit C and optimize it here. Don't forget to optimize when you do something like this. So then I press here UL, go to my polygon mode. So I for inner extruder, just as I said, I make a rough cage. This it has not to be very exactly so something like this. Of course, it's more accurate to do it, it's better the result will be. This is, but I want to do it fast here, so okay, this is nice. Then we make the same here. L I. Something like that. E, and bring this down here. So I have a cage, and I want some subdivisions here so that this can move a little bit. So we just, it's on you. With KL I can make some loop cuts. So I make 1, 2, 3. It's really not. So. Not too many, because when it's too many, we have the same problem again. So, this is okay. And maybe let's cut here one and here two. So, give it here one maybe. What wouldn't be necessary, but. Okay, so we have a cage around our object here. Now I hide the original one for the moment, and now I give this cylinder this cage here, so name it cage. And now I give this one a rigid body. So, but let's again take both of them. R for rotation, and rotate it a little bit so that we get a funnier thing here. Okay, let's see if we, yeah, everything works. And now gets a rigid body. Of course, this is no problem now. This is blush. Okay, and if I go now to the soft body here, it is the wrong layout, of course. Here, so, and go to polygon and lines. Let's see what we get now. I'm sure we can press play here. So, see, okay, boing. Okay, that works. Let's go with the stiffness here to around 50. And let's see what it does now. Okay. What I don't like is here on the top the thing. So what I do is we have too many. Do I need polygons here? Let's see. I don't think that we need polygons. UL, whoopity whoopity, and delete it. And with MD I can close the hole. Let's see how this looks here when we do this with a soft body. Let's optimize it. See, just when we are here. So and try it again. This was what I said, we could have used less of the of these segments here. But if you know what I do, I have time a little bit, so new elder is not what I want, no. No, I want something like no. Okay, then I do it differently. So I select with double click, I select here every second one. This is not so many work, can do it here too. This is okay, MN for dissolve, and I have halved. And now let's see how this looks with the soft body dynamics. Yes, this is what I like more. We can even go maybe up with the sub steps. So with Control D, I go in my project settings to dynamics, to the experts, because we are experts. And let's go up 10 maybe. Okay, soft body settings. What could we do here? Now with the elastic limit, I don't want to go down because then it's 0/10. Does not matter. When I go down, it does not go back as far as I know. Yes. Nope. Well, 80 I went. Yeah, but we will see what I mean, how it works. So, okay. We have a soft body, but I wonder today, you know what I mean? I want to flip it around. So, why it does it? I don't like the soft body, if I'm honest. And you know I'm honest. That, for me, nothing makes sense here. But doesn't matter. I just want to show you. Let's make a different rotation, maybe then it works better. So it sticks to the floor. This is Control D and go here to 15 maybe. Why it is like this? It's really very, very rarely that it works like I want. But it doesn't matter. I want to just show you. It doesn't matter. I just want to show you how this works with the... you can play with this by yourself later. So, we have a soft body. And we have a cage here. And this is the high poly version. So, let's bring in the high poly version. What I do now is... Come on, so I give the volume mesher here, the high poly version, in mesh deformer. This is this here, mesh deformer. And you see in the mesh deformer we have cages. And I drag in this cage. Whoops, cage. And now I hit on initialize. First, and I go first to ignore here, maybe this is okay, if not, we... So you see. On our cages now got a display tag, and this display tag is set to lines. Here, this display tag is set to lines, but I don't want to see it anyway. So, and now because of the mesh tag, when I hit now, play, the cage falls down, and the high poly version against the position of the points of the cage. So that looks then like this. Okay, we have some problems, but you see it works. So with this problem, I go to my mesh here. Let's see, surface area. Okay, and you see we have our low poly cage with our high poly thing. But maybe we can make this a little bit. I don't like this on the floor. I'll take instead of this floor, I try it with a cylinder. Sometimes it works better with a cylinder and give it more cap segments. Okay, and this is a collider body. Let's see if this works better. Yeah, that works much better. Okay, and you see now we have a very high dense mesh and we can work with high poly objects. That was the reason that I did not like the floor. And of course, more exactly you do this, but you see that it works quite nice. Let's go to the dibidibidip. So let's go to the soft body here. Give it one. So. Should stick on the block. Nope. Structure zero. Stiffness here to 100. Let's play with the settings and see what we get. So it looks everything the same. But you see, it works quite well. It works really nice. And NA, so we see that like this. Do, do, do. Okay, this is how you can work with proxy objects. Make a cage around your object, then make a mesh deformer. In the mesh deformer, you drag your cage in and initialize, of course, and then try it and you just see if you have problems with this ignore thing here, like we have here. Okay, sometimes it looks out somewhere, so you can try this surface or surface area. Surface is okay here too here. And we are done. I like it. I like this movement. Let's see. Okay, the soft body isn't that bad. It was the floor, so the disc only. Boom. But as I said, when I'm honest, I have every time problem with these things. Okay, why not? In the woo, give it 100. The funny thing is, it takes immediately over the settings. So it's 100. It should be better. Let's go to 20 here. Whoop, zooming. And now 200. You see, it takes over the settings immediately. Okay, maybe a little pressure for fun. More pressure for more fun. Okay, that was a little too much, I think. But it still works great. It's fifty. No idea what I do here, sir. So you can blow up your objects. That's funny too. 70. Voo. Do. Yeah, why not? It makes fun. Okay, so now you know how this works. And you can do this with everything. If you have more, let's say if you have this volume measure and another object and something else within, let's say you have another, you say now I want another thing here. Let's go to this. This is wrong, so set it back to zero here, so. And if you say, okay, I want now another cylinder or whatever, or a torus here, like E, want a torus here. This makes no sense, I know it, but just to show you what I mean, now we can go to the cache here, to the cage, not to the cache, the cage. Don't need to, and go to here, so delete this one for the moment. Oops, this was too much. There is something wrong. What's happened, sir? Okay. Why I cannot delete this? This is fun. Maybe it has to do with the soft body tech here. Soft body tech and dynamics. Disable it to dynamics. And delete it now. No. Anyway, it doesn't matter. T for scale, control, drag it out here, so. Something like that. E. Whoop. Okay. Huh? The torus has to go a little up here, so. Would be easier from this side. Okay, so cage, control, drag this up here. Okay, and yeah, I don't know, delete this one here. And close this with quads. So I have here a small, the link is in the description for this quad caps here. This is a plugin that it costs, I think, about $5 or something else. But this is really handy, so if you click on it, check, it closes everything with nice quads. So, okay. We have this now. First, don't forget to optimize. Now, this is in our cage. And now, of course, the torus is not together with this volume measure. What I want now is bring out the mesh here for the moment. Well, I delete the mesh for the moment. I make a connect object. Boop. Bring the torus inside and the volume measure. Now they are these two guys are connected. This let's say it's one object with the connect object. What I do now is, with Alt G, I bring the connect object in the null, and under the null, I bring in the mesh object. And the cage is again the cage with the thing now what we did with the torus. In the cage object, drag in the cage, initialize. Let's go to surface here. And now everything should fall down with the torus and everything, and let's see if it's true. At the moment not, because we have disabled our thing here. Woo. See. Let's again rotate everything a little bit. So. And whoop. You see, even the torus is now a soft body. It's in the connect object, and it's a soft body now. So everything together works fine now. Whoop, 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 whoop. And this, I think, is really nice. Okay, so now I can say, let's stop here. And so you can make with a very high poly object, you can still make dynamics. So, okay. Hope it was something you need or you did not know or you forgot, whatever. And yeah, that's it for now. And next tutorial will come soon. And if you have questions, requests, and so you know my words, blah, 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 blah. Write the description, read the description, please. If you want to donate or if you want to support me on Patreon, you find everything in the description. If you have requests, complaints, whatever, write me from here in the comments, Facebook, email, you have everywhere where you want. Okay, so that's it. And have fun with it. Yeah, and yeah, tschüss und baba.